many teachers have heard from Smekens Education the power of the sports analogy when planning and delivering explicit comprehension instruction. We talk a lot about that mini lesson is like the coach holding the ball and teaching his or her team a new play. In this case, a new reading play. And then if we continue with the sports analogy, the idea would be after the coach teaches explicitly something new, that the kids, the players, the readers, then scrimmage. The coach is nearby, helping out and supporting, because ultimately we're shooting for independence. That kids can do this kind of reading, thinking, and comprehending alone and with grade level text. Okay, now, with this process, the idea is that we first teach a skill to the class, right? They watch us really break it down, but then we want them to try it. That's the scrimmage, where the coach is nearby and the kids are trying it. And then again, ultimately, the coach can call the play and the kids can execute it independently and flawlessly in the game. All right. I want to talk for a minute about this teaching time, this explicit mini lesson. When we teach a comprehension skill, we deliver it to the class, and we honor four-step best practice mini lesson instruction. And if you've heard Smekens talk about this, then you talk about then you've heard us say it's all about teaching. Teaching thinking. So we can't have really long text in the mini lesson. We've got to have short text, even thinking in the form of excerpts, the least amount of text in the mini lesson, so you can focus in on the thinking. This is totally true. However, in learning this, some teachers have gotten a different thought in their mind. In addition to this, they think that means we don't use the passages in the basal. We don't use those long interactive read-alouds. Why? Because they're too long. No. That's not true. This idea of using the longer passages is absolutely necessary. You need them for the scrimmage. You're not going to read the full basal passage or the whole interactive read aloud or the whole chapter in a chapter book in the lesson. No, but you do need it for the scrimmage. You guys, there are benefits to longer passages. You need the long passages in the basal. You're just not going to read those long passages in the whole class lesson. No, there you need to read them outside the whole class lesson. After the coach has broken down the skill in the lesson, then we want the kids to be scrimmaging with that skill, and not just that skill, but all previous comprehension skills, using context clues, making predictions, wondering about author choices, all while summarizing the text. See, the scrimmage is when they juggle multiple skills you've taught. And we do that with a longer text and a grade level text. See, that's the other perk of using your basal passages outside of the mini lesson, is you know their grade level complexity. You know, because you might have used a simpler passage in the lesson to teach the thinking, but when we scrimmage, we got to raise that rigor. Yeah. Okay, here's another benefit to longer passages. Stamina, right? I mean, we're only using little excerpts to teach thinking in the whole class lesson, but outside the lesson, in a read aloud, a whole class read aloud, a shared reading experience, we need our kids to see how long text is at their grade level and the fact that it goes across days at times while they're scrimmaging. Also keep in mind that some of the standards require us to have longer text to see development, to see relationship, to see author choices and patterns across the text. So you absolutely need this longer text outside of the mini lesson. Here's a third reason you need those long passages. You need them for content area connections. All the passages in the fourth grade basal are also tied to science concepts and social studies concepts. Yeah, so what we're doing is building background knowledge and vocabulary and seeing those concepts now in other ways outside of the science text and social studies text. Not to mention, some of the things just in your reading series are going to just build their background worldly knowledge, just about events in history, not even ones you're studying, but just building their background knowledge in general on life concepts, text-to-world concepts that we all know as adults. When did the kids learn them? through those passages. Hey, you guys, there are benefits to the basal. Absolutely, you need short, little, limited text in the lesson, but outside the lesson, you need long passages.